This is the OTB Network.
Welcome to this week's edition of Horses and Courses, brought to you by Parting Glass Racing. I'm Jean Wood. We've just finished up a busy weekend of stakes racing action. We've got a lot to bring to you, and we'll begin at Delaware Park, where on Saturday it was two-year-olds in action at a mile and a 16th in the Dover Stakes.
And they're off in the Dover. To the inside, La Venganza breaks well. S. Joe is right there. Bunker Hill up on the far outside. Balraj in between horses, but with that rail, La Venganza will lead him into that first turn. Ask Joe toward the inside, now easing up alongside of that leader, followed by Balraj, caught three wide on the far outside. It's Bunker Hill who lost position there and has to drop back. RB Lion King found the rail nicely and quickly moves up into contention. But it's La Venganza showing the way around the quarter in 24-1. Leads it by a length and a half over Ask Joe, settles nicely in second. Balraj to the outside, RB Lion King with that rail. Bunker Hill racing a close-up fifth. A length further back to Count on Lou, and Aspiring Nick has been taken back to last as they move down the back stretch. On the front end, La Venganza, now Ask Joe, is edged a bit closer. A length and a quarter to Balraj in third. Bunker Hill begins to extend stride on the outside, followed by RB Lion King. Between horses, Aspiring Nick now angles to the inside for clear sailing and begins to make a run. Count on Lou is now your trailer, but only about 4.5 lengths separates the field after a moderate half in 49-2. Into the turn, it's still La Venganza on the front end. Ask Joe lapped right alongside in perfect striking position. A length further back to Bunker Hill. Toward the inside, Balraj. Aspiring Nick is edged closer and still striding nicely. Then Count on Lou and dropping back on the inside. The trailer, RB Lion King, quarter to go, and here comes Ask Joe to take on the leaders, the 6-14-1. Ask Joe now to the front, being pursued by Bunker Hill, Aspiring Nick on the far outside. Those three are going to fight it out a furlong to go. Ask Joe is digging in on the outside, Aspiring Nick and Gamely hanging in there, Bunker Hill between horses. Aspiring Nick and Bunker Hill head-to-head in the final 16th of a mile. It's Bunker Hill, Aspiring Nick, Aspiring Nick. Bunker Hill is game on the inside. The head bob, oh! It could go to the bigger one, Aspiring Nick, but right there on the inside, Bunker Hill, followed by Ask Joe and RB Lion King.
Aspiring Nick turning the tables here on Bunker Hill. These two had run in the opposite order last time out in the off-the-turf Gopher Green. In fact, it looks like Aspiring Nick's connections, after having seen him hit the board twice and off the turfers, just decided to try a dirt race after all. Here they score the victory by a game nose from off the pace over Bunker Hill with Ask Joe back in third. The winner, Aspiring Nick, is a chestnut two-year-old son of Graham Hall from Aspiring Sue by Proof, bred in Florida by Daniel J. Loca and Sharon B. Amante, owned by Daniel J. Loca and trained by Tim Kelly, ridden to victory by Mario Pino. Aspiring Nick covers the mile in the 16th and 147 flat. We'll stay in the Mid-Atlantic and head back to last Friday evening at the Meadowlands in the running of the Cliffhanger.
They're racing in the Cliffhanger, and Ballast started well from the inside. From the outside, Baron Von Tapp, though, will grab the lead. It's Baron Von Tapp to the front, getting to the lead by a length and a half. And then it's Wheels Up at Noon, Kiss the Kid, and Ballast on the inside. Gap of 2.5 back to Forget About It Sal, who's fifth early, 5.5 lengths off the pace. And Ball One, no strikes. Icy Atlantic, break of another two to Nergal, who is second last early and leading just the trailer. Victory alleged. 24-1, the first quarter for Baron Von Tapp, who leads the way early here. It's a 2.5 length lead to Wheels Up at Noon and Kiss the Kid. Ballast follows them in fourth, 5 lengths off the lead. It's another 3.5 foot back, and then comes Forget About It Sal. Ball One, no strikes, is gaining a bit of ground on the inside. Icy Atlantic is 9 lengths from the front right now. Then Nergal and Victory Alleged continues to race in the back through a 48 flat half mile. And it's Baron Von Tapp on top by a length and a half, with Wheels Up at Noon and Kiss the Kid keeping close company. Ballast follows in fourth, 3.5 lengths off the lead. At the rail, Nergal is next. and it's a length and a half back to ball one, no strikes. Icy Atlantic is right behind horses. He needs to get moving, though. He's now 5.5 lengths off the lead, and Baron Von Tapp turns for home in front. Kiss the Kid is right alongside, Ballast up and after them, and then Nergal, and squeezing through and opening on the inside is Wheels Up at Noon, and they're into the final furlong, and here's Wheels Up at Noon trying to catch Kiss the Kid. Kiss the Kid's got the lead, though, and Kiss the Kid wins the cliffhanger over Wheels Up at Noon. Nergal was next, and then came Ballast.
Nice group of turf horses going postward here on a good surface, and at the end it was Kiss the Kid at 6-1 and neck in front of another 6-1 shot, Wheels Up at Noon, who I thought offered a big price here at almost 7-1. It was Nergal finishing in the third spot with his usual off-the-pace run. The winner, Kiss the Kid, was never a factor last time out behind Big Brown and Proudinsky in the Monmouth Stakes, but prior to that had run well to finish third in the Island and second on the turf of the Bob Harding. Finally gets that elusive stakes victory, Kiss the Kid, a dark bay or brown son of Lemon Drop Kid from Black Tie Kiss by Danzig, was bred in Kentucky by the JFB stable and is owned by Hardacre Farm Limited. Trained by Amy Tarrant and ridden to victory by Rajiv Marah, Kiss the Kid covers the mile on the 16th on the good turf surface in 143.60. We'll head into the Saturday evening card now at the Meadowlands and the Seton Hall University Stakes for three-year-olds and up, fillies and mares, sprinters.
The racing in the Seton Hall University Stakes. And Zeta Belle came out running. Shanani Song on the inside is going to go with her, though, and Princess Janie is too. And these three will sprint it out early on. It's two lengths back to Solarana, who races outside of Bully Bones in the back. Up the back stretch, and Shanani Song and Joe Hampshire have taken the lead. Zeta Belle is right alongside, though, through a quarter and 22 and 2/5 seconds. Princess Janie a length and a half off the lead. On the inside, it's Bully Bones, and right alongside Solarana. Round the far turn, and Zeta Belle now pokes ahead in front. Shanani Song second on the rail. Princess Janie lays just off the leaders. Solarana circled up on the outside, fourth. And Bully Bones in the back. 45-1 for the half. They're into the stretch. Zeta Belle still getting tested by Shanani Song. Princess Janie and Solarana are trying to close in into the final furlong. Zeta Belle starting to get away now. Shanani Song next. Princess Janie on the outside. Zeta Belle and Stuart Elliott have won it by two over Shanani Song and Princess Janie.
Zeta Belle scoring the victory here. Last out, she was fourth behind Indian Blessing in the Gallant Bloom. But when dropped down a little bit in class company here, she picks up the win to run a record 5-for-8 lifetime. Particularly strong in the sprinting game. She sits just off the pace and wins by 2.5 as she plays this under Stu Elliott from Shanani Song with Princess Janie back in third. Zeta Belle is a 3-year-old bay filly, a daughter of Indian Charlie from Three of a Kind by Carson City. Bred in Florida by Scott Lanier and owned by Godolphin Racing, trained by Saeed Bin Soror and ridden to victory by Stu Elliott, Zeta Belle covers the 6 furlongs in 109.12. We'll head to the Chicago area now, where Hawthorne on Saturday hosted the Grade 3 Hawthorne Derby for 3-year-olds on grass.
They're off in the Hawthorne Derby. Adriano going right to the front towards the inside. Mr. Mischief is there in between those two, Cherokee Triangle. Here's Rob Skarvik now ranging up on the outside as they pass us for the first time. Rob Skarvik from the outside now takes a short lead. Mr. Mischief battles on second. Cherokee Triangle on the rail third. Adriano alongside that one for Denim. Caught 5 wide into the first turn is fifth. Snooze Goose racing in sixth. Let It Rock now seventh and the early trailer straight of Musina. And around the turn to the back stretch, Rob Skarvik leads by a length and a half. Mr. Mischief now moves to the outside and is gaining ground second. And then it's 3 lengths back, Cherokee Triangle third, Adriano fourth, 7 lengths behind the leader. Denim still taking the wide trip out there in fifth. Let It Rock down along the rail, trying to advance six. Snooze Goose seventh. Straight of Musina can see them all. He's 8 lengths behind the leader with a half mile to run in the 2008 Hawthorne Derby. And Rob Skarvik holds firm on neck. On the outside, Mr. Mischief racing in second. Cherokee Triangle third. Towards the inside, Let It Rock continues to gain ground fourth. Adriano on the outside with Killer Sailing, but still needs to make up five. And then it's Snooze Goose Denim. Straight of Mucina starts to move from the back of the pack while racing on the rail. They turn for home in the 2008 Hawthorne Derby. And Rob Skarvik comes off the turn with the lead. Mr. Mischief now between horses. Adriano out in the center of the course third. Down along the inside, gaining ground fourth, comes Cherokee Triangle, a 16th to go. Adriano, Cherokee Triangle is gaining on the inside. It's Adriano the leader. Cherokee Triangle closing on the outside. Here comes Straight Up Mucina. Straight Up Mucina got up to win it. Cherokee Triangle second. It's very tight for third.
Straight Up Mucina at 19.5-1 pulls off an upset. This horse had been unplaced in several prior tries. In Stakes Company, last out was sixth in Kentucky in a Kentucky Downs allowance race, but here turns the tables with a rallying run to a neck victory over Cherokee Triangle with Snooze Goose back in the third spot. Disappointing was Adriano. The heavy favorite at odds on got into contention with a wide bid at the top of the lane, but was outfinished to finish fourth. The winner, Straight Of Mucina, a bay three-year-old son of Spartacus from Siraca by Grand Lodge, was bred in Ireland by Frank Rotondo. Owned by Richard Ravin and trained by Larry Ravelli. Ridden to victory by E.T. Baird, Straight Of Mucina covers the 9 furlongs and 149.98. We will head now north of the border to the Toronto area, Woodbine, hosting the Durham Cup for older horses.
They're off in the Durham Cup. Head Chopper to the inside, and showing early speed is Monsoon Rain. Head Chopper, Monsoon Rain, and Can't Beat It's taken in hand in third. Palladio is in fourth position. Then we have a Ghost Hour. They head for the first turn, and Monsoon Rain is sent to the front by Carlos Marquez. They come to the 7/8 pole. Monsoon Rain's placed off the rail and leads a Head Chopper through that first turn. That opening quarter was slow, 24-4. Palladio's in hand third. Back in a fourth position is a Can't Beat It. Marchfield saved ground through the turn. Artie Hot, square of trouble on the outside. Sixth and 4.5 lengths off the lead. That one followed by Ghost Dower, who has one beaten. That's Torquay, and it's Monsoon Rain. Monsoon Rain leads it by a length through an opening half mile in 49-1. Monsoon Rain. Now taking to the outside is Head Chopper. Head Chopper didn't like it down on the rail. Has been moved to the outside by Chantel Sutherland with less than a half mile to go. And Monsoon Rain and Head Chopper lock horns for the run into the turn. Palladio's sitting chilly to the outside third. Marchfield's in behind runners. Can't Beat It needs a way out. Ghost Hour's making up ground. Artie Hot's just 2.5 lengths off the lead. Torquay trails. Tight group as they come over to the quarter pole. Head Chopper in the center. Palladio glides up to challenge Head Chopper. Palladio traveling extremely well. Monsoon Rain is tailed off, and Palladio gets a nudge from Dos Ramos, asks him to run on. Ghost Dower is on the outside. Head Chopper had no response. Marchfield comes between horses. Palladio with 1/16 to the wire. On the outside is Marchfield. Palladio outstanding in the Durham Cup, defeating Marchfield and Artie Hot with Torquay fourth.
Palladio, good to see this guy back in action. And now that they have that synthetic surface, this guy primarily earned his reputation as a turf horse. Obviously handles the synthetic fairly nicely. He scores by a length and 3/4 at almost 6-1 over Marchfield with Artie Hot, rallying well to finish third. The winner, Palladio, 7th last time out in the Woodbine Mile, but that third off the layoff handicapping angle proved successful here. Palladio is a bay son of Lysias from Gioia by Mary's Book. Bred in Florida by the Ara Santa Maria de Arradas and owned by the breeder and trained by Roger Atfield, ridden to victory by Richard Dos Ramos. Palladio covers the mile and an eighth in 149.29. We'll pause now for a brief message. When we return, we'll be heading to Kentucky for a week's worth of stakes racing action from Keeneland. Please stay with us. We'll be right back. Welcome back to Horses and Courses. We'll continue now at Keeneland, where last Thursday they ran the J.P. Morgan Chase Jessamine for two-year-old fillies on the turf, a win and you're in Breeders' Cup event.
And they're off to the J.P. Morgan Chase Jessamine. Glamorous Gal is away in good order and comes out for the lead. LaRaw is there from the outside, and LaRaw now strides forward to take the advantage. Glamorous Gal is second toward her inside. Complicity comes away, running in the third position as they head for the first turn. Maybe Baby moves up in fourth. Never Lie is a wide fifth. Tobias sixth back toward the rail. And then War Tigress, who goes seventh outward from the rail, five lengths off the lead around the first turn. Hint of Lemon is caught three wide and moves up on the far outside into the eighth spot. Fola ninth. Abbott Hall is 10th in between horses, heading onto the back stretch. And then Lake Cook is running in the 11th spot. And finally, it's Tiffin time, 12th and last, 22-4 for the opening quarter. Back up front, LaRaw against the rail, leads it by two lengths. Up the back stretch, Glamorous Gal second, a length and a half. Never Lie to the far outside, Complicity toward the rail. Maybe Baby between those two travels in the third position in that three-way shuffle for the third spot. War Tigress behind that trio, five lengths off the lead as they go into the far turn. Habaya is between horses looking for running room, also five from the front. Fola to her inside. Abbott Hall has to go wide, six lengths off the lead. And then Lake Cook, it's Tiffin time, and Hint of Lemon is last. 47-1, the time for the half. And LaRaw continues to show the way. LaRaw by four lengths off the far turn. Glamorous Gal second. Complicity is third at the top of the stretch. They all have to catch LaRaw, who leads it by five lengths, coming to the eighth pole. Habaya trying to track down Complicity, who's second. Habaya third. Abbott Hall, a late run, the fourth. Deep stretch, final furlong of the J.P. Morgan Chase Jessamine. LaRaw and Edgar Prado well clear of Habaya, then Complicity and Abbott Hall. It is LaRaw to pull the upset. LaRaw wins it by four. Habaya second, Complicity third. Abbott Hall was fourth.
LaRaw picking up the victory here. She had making her first start with John Terranova, recently acquired by a portion of her acquired by IEAH Stables, moving to New York from her Woodbine base. She had run fifth in the Natalma last time out, but here improves her form nicely to win off fairly easily over Habaya, a recent debut maiden winner at Belmont, with Complicity sitting just off the pace and settling for third. The winner, LaRaw, is a two-year-old Grey Roan, daughter of Tappet from Rose of Summer by El Prado. Bred in Kentucky by Mike Ryan, owned by Golden Goose Enterprises Limited and IEAH Stable, trained by John Terranova, ridden to victory by Edgar Prado. LaRaw covers the mile and a 16th in 143.54. Next, we'll head right back to Keeneland. The Buffalo Trace Franklin County, three-year-olds and up, fillies and mares sprinting on turf.
And they're off. See the Joy comes out running for the lead. Tale to be Told is there with American County toward the inside. American County moves up the rail to challenge See the Joy with Tale to be Told third between them. Sly Storm away fourth. Ad Silver fifth between horses. Game and Laughing is next toward the rail. Natalie Cat caught to the far outside as they go to the far turn. Four lengths off the lead. Creative Design is toward the inside. Five lengths from the front. In it for the Candy is next on the outside. And Caterbug is 10th and last. 22 seconds flat the time for the opening quarter. See the Joy on the outside challenging American County once again for the top spot. Two more lengths to Sly Storm in third. Tale to be Told fourth, nearly five lengths off the lead. Ad Silver is fifth, and Natalie Cat, Game and Laughing, and Creative Design, they turn for home. See the Joy, American County, Sly Storm to join them. Tale to be Told is fourth, Creative Design is fifth. Ad Silver is sixth past the eighth pole. Sly Storm head in front. And See the Joy fights on toward the inside in second. Coming to the line in the Buffalo Trace Franklin County, Ad Silver is charging late from the outside. Tale to be Told coming late. Creative Design, Sly Storm, short lead. Sly Storm hanging on to take it by a neck.
Sly Storm picking up the victory here. She made a nice bid three wide while just outside of horses throughout the running and scored by a neck over a dead heating Tale to be Told and Ad Silver, who shared the play spot. Tale to be Told as the 5-2 favorite. Ad Silver as a 15-1 outsider, splitting that place pool rather dramatically. The winner, Sly Storm, had won the Mongo Queen and off the turfer down at Monmouth over the summer. She was dull at Saratoga in the victory ride, but returned to win a turf sprint allowance at Arlington, giving them the idea that perhaps that would be a good game for her. They moved her into stakes company and scored the victory. The winner, Sly Storm, a bay daughter of Storm Cat from Brush Tallery by Broadbrush, was bred in Kentucky by Racehorse Management Limited and is owned by the Glen Hill Farm, trained by Tom Proctor and ridden to victory by Jamie Theriault. Sly Storm covers the 5.5 in 103.60. We'll head into the Saturday card now at Keeneland. We'll start things out with the Perryville Stakes, presented by Budweiser Select. $200,000 for three-year-olds going the about 7 furlong distance.
And they're off. Nickel Shooter broke alertly with Fidelio toward the inside. Eaton's Gift now moving up onto the main track. Here comes Eaton's Gift to put a head in front. Nickel Shooter will go second. Wise Answer third. Fidelio fourth in between horses. Meal Penalty is away running in the fifth position. And then Liberty Bowl on the outside. But up front, Eaton's Gift has the lead by only a half length. Fidelio and Wise Answer move side by side to the outside of the leader. Nickel Shooter is fourth. Meal Penalty fifth. I'm So Lucky, sixth against the rail, 5 lengths off the lead. Liberty Bowl goes seventh. Amazing Results is eighth. Had a Fort is running in ninth, and a gap of three more back to Godolphin Gray, who's 10th and last, 22-2 for the opening quarter. Eaton's Gift leading Fidelio 3/4 of a length into the far turn. Wise Answer third on the far outside, gap of two. Back to Nickel Shooter. I'm So Lucky is between horses, still 4.5 lengths off the lead. Meal Penalty to his outside around the far turn. And then Liberty Bowl, who's got 5 lengths to make up. And Eaton's Gift, still the one to catch through a half in 44 4/5 seconds. Fidelio, the Nickel Shooter, Wise Answer, I'm So Lucky, dives down toward the rail from fourth. Has plenty of work to do. Amazing Results is moving on the far outside and moving fast. Amazing Results is charging. Had a Fort is running late toward the rail. They've got to get Eaton's Gift. I'm So Lucky kicks in again. Amazing Results far outside. Had a Fort charging up the rail. Amazing Results. Had a Fort from the inside. Head bobbing photo for the win. Had a Fort or Amazing Results.
Had a Fort scoring the victory here from well back off the pace by a game neck over Amazing Results with I'm So Lucky. Also launching a bit of a bid, perhaps a little bit of an early move to finish in the third spot. The winner, Had a Fort, had won an allowance race up at Saratoga, sprinting on the turf, very sharp form. Came back and was fourth in the Kentucky Cup sprint on the synthetic at Turfway Park, but here rallies and gets all the way to the front to win by a neck. Had a Fort is a bay son of Cape Cross from Oshapanga by Barathea. Bred in Great Britain by Well Summers Farm and owned by Godolphin Racing, trained by Saeed Bin Soror and ridden to victory by Julian Leperoux, Had a Fort covers the about distance of 7 furlongs and 125.97. We'll stay with the Saturday card at Keeneland and head next back to the turf course for the Queen Elizabeth II Challenge Cup, 3-year-old fillies and Grade 1 company.
And they're off in the Queen Elizabeth II Challenge Cup. Backseat Rhythm broke well. So did Storm Mesa toward the inside. I'll watch a haw between those two. My Baby Baby from the far outside. And Storm Mesa comes to the front to take the early lead by 2 lengths. Alwajaha goes second just outside of Ariege in third. Close out between horses. My Baby Baby on her outside as they go to the first turn. Rosa Grace is moving up down toward the rail right behind Safrua, who settles out 6 lengths off the early lead, moving midway on the turn. Up front, Storm Mesa leads it by some 3 lengths, 3.5 now. Back to Alwajaha. My Baby Baby third on the outside. Ariege fourth against the rail. Close out fifth between horses. My Princess Jess a wide sixth onto the back stretch. Safrua seventh. Backseat Rhythm eighth. Rosa Grace in ninth. Lickety Lemon travels along in 10th position. And Magical Fantasy 11th and last. 23-1 for the quarter. 47 seconds the time for the half. And Storm Mesa the leader. Storm Mesa leads it by 2. Alwajaha second by a length. The My Baby Baby third on the far outside. Ariege now picks it up down toward the rail from fourth up to challenge for third. Close out is up close to the pace in between horses in the fifth position. Just 3 lengths off the lead into the far turn. Then My Princess Jess on the outside. And up front, here comes Alwajaha reeling in the leader, Storm Mesa. Alwajaha alongside. Close out goes to third. Ariege is fourth back toward the rail. My Baby Baby, then My Princess Jess. Safrua back toward the inside, 5 lengths away. Alwajaha, the new leader, to Storm Mesa, then close out in Ariege fourth. They're coming to the eighth pole. My Princess Jess is fifth. Backseat Rhythm is sixth. Final furlong of the QE2. Alwajaha, Ariege close out. My Princess Jess. Backseat Rhythm, the Magical Fantasy. Alwajaha, My Princess Jess, and Backseat Rhythm. Alwajaha, My Princess Jess, Backseat Rhythm. Alwajaha pulls the upset in the QE2 for John Velasquez.
Alwa Jiha picking up the victory here, turning the tables on Backseat Rhythm, who is one of those fillies just never seems to get a lot of respect at the windows, which I certainly appreciate. She was 4-1. Alwa Jiha, who had been beaten fairly handily by her last time out, by Backseat Rhythm last time out, went off at almost 12-1. Shows good early speed and wins off by a length and a quarter from Backseat Rhythm, with My Princess Jess making a 4-wide bid to rally into the third spot. The winner, Alwa Jiha, is a daughter of Dixieland Band from Reda by Seattle Slough, bred in Kentucky by Shadwell Farm Limited and owned by Shadwell Stable. Trained by Karen McLaughlin and ridden to victory by John Velasquez, who was back after that rather frightening incident on opening week of Keeneland, or a week or so ago at Keeneland, where he was involved in a rather dangerous-looking spill. He did suffer a concussion, but obviously good to have Johnny V back in the irons and back in grade one company. Alwa Jiha covers the mile and a furlong in 148.09. One more stake to bring to you from Keeneland. That's Sunday's stakes feature, 3-year-olds at a mile on the turf in the Bryan Station.
And they're off in the Bryan Station. Cowboy Cal comes right to the front out of the gate. C-Speak is there on the outside. Reddy's Image and St. Joe toward the inside. And there goes St. Joe hustling up to take the lead. St. Joe goes to the front, leads it by a length and a half into the first turn. Reddy's Image to the inside of Cowboy Cal to challenge that one for second in the early going. Mr. McCool moves 3 wide into the fourth position onto the backstretch. C-Speak is now in the fifth position. Montana Mike on the far outside is 6th in the early going. Big Stick is 7th between horses. Nisley's Crunch is 8th against the rail. St. Joe, meanwhile, has opened up on a 5-length lead up the backstretch. Further back at the back of the field, deal making toward the inside as the field hits the midpoint of the back straightaway. Coronel Moldez is behind that one as they go to the far turn. Veiled Prophet also has ground to make up. 46 seconds was the time for the opening half. And it's all St. Joe chased by Cowboy Cal. Still 4 lengths between them. C-Speak goes to third around the outside of Reddy's Image. Big Stick between horses. Nisley's Crunch toward the inside, who's still running 7 lengths off the lead. And here comes Cowboy Cal to tackle the leader, St. Joe. C-Speak in striking distance, third on the outside. Big Stick is gearing up to the grandstand side in fourth. Nisley's Crunch is fifth. Reddy's Image is sixth. Cowboy Cal and C-Speak come to the front together at the eighth pole. A narrow lead for Cowboy Cal. C-Speak is alongside the leader. The rest are far back. Deal making to third. Cowboy Cal is ahead in front. C-Speak is there on the outside. Cowboy Cal, long shot C-Speak, down to the line. C-Speak from the outside. Look to get ahead in front of the wire over Cowboy Cal in the Bryan Station.
Cowboy Cal getting the victory on the DQ of Longshot C-Speak, who was 12-1 in this field. And the two of them coming down the wire, it was a little bit of give and take there, some bumping. Cowboy Cal taking the worst of it, and the stewards taking C-Speak away from the win spot, moving him down to second and giving Cowboy Cal the victory. Good to see him back here, and worth also mentioning, deal making. Rallied well from off the pace to finish third. The winner, Cowboy Cal, has not been seen in action in the afternoon since the Kentucky Derby. He finished ninth that day after having run very well when moved onto the turf last year. They tried him on the poly track. He ran well on the poly track in the bluegrass. I believe he finished second that afternoon behind stablemate Mamba. Rebounded it, not a bad effort at all in the Kentucky Derby to finish ninth, and now returns off of the long layoff with a nice performance. Cowboy Cal, who I think will probably in the long term find his home on the turf, scores here on the DQ. Cowboy Cal is a dark bay or brown son of Giant's Causeway from Texas Tammy by Seeking the Gold. Bred in Kentucky by Stonerside Stable, owned by Robert C. and Janice McNair, trained by Todd Pletcher, and ridden to victory by John Velasquez. Cowboy Cal covers the mile in 135.70. We'll pause now for one more brief message. When we return, we'll head out to California for a trio of races from Santa Anita and head back home to New York at Belmont. Please stay with us. Welcome back to Horses and Courses. We'll continue now in Southern California, where on Saturday the stakes feature at Oak Tree at Santa Anita was the Harold C. Ramser Sr., a grade three at a mile for three-year-old fillies on turf.
And away they go. Dawn Before Dawn breaks fast and goes straight for the lead. Tasha's Miracle Content to tuck in second. Solomus is third. Gorgeous Goose is the grey, taken back second last. And Miss Sing Six, the early trailer. Into the turn they go, and Dawn Before Dawn, setting off at a decent pace out here, goes along a length and a half in front. Tasha's Miracle going to tuck right in behind her in the second spot. Then we have a gap of three back to Solar Miss. Down at the rail comes Miss Sing Six, and Gorgeous Goose is still the trailer, gives them seven length start. Onto the backstretch they go, and Garrett Gomez and Dawn Before Dawn, all alone out here, just on a long rein, taking them along by just over length. But Tasha's Miracle's very keen to go on. She doesn't want to tuck in behind, but the rider's making her sit right there in the second spot. Then a gap of three back to Solar Miss. Inside of that comes Miss Sing Six, and still Gorgeous Goose is the trailer, now six off the leaders. Into the turn they go, and Dawn Before Dawn now kicks for home, and Dawn Before Dawn tries to sneak away from them, opens up three and a half lengths. But now Tasha's Miracle starts to come back at her, and Tasha's Miracle traveling awfully well in second. Dawn Before Dawn tries to find more on the lead. Then we come back to Miss Sing Six. Gorgeous Goose is still last. Heads a turn for home. Dawn Before Dawn goes on with it. Being chased now by Tasha's Miracle. Miss Sing Six in the center of the track. Gorgeous Goose getting going late. They come for home now, and Tasha's Miracle, Gorgeous Goose flying on the inside. Gorgeous Goose coming like an express train. Tasha's Miracle, Gorgeous Goose, Gorgeous Goose, Tasha's Miracle. That one is so close. Could be a dead heat, in fact. Gorgeous Goose, Tasha's Miracle hit it together, and then Dawn Before Dawn.
Tasha's Miracle, nice to see this filly back into the winner's circle. She had been a very good two-year-old early last year, was winless since her two-year-old season, but had run some good races, including running second in the San Clemente at Del Mar to Storm Mesa. A very nice performance here in game fashion as she wins by a nose over Gorgeous Goose with Dawn Before Dawn, showing good speed and settling for third. Tasha's Miracle is a bay three-year-old daughter of Harlan's Holiday from Miss Cuvée Napa by Relaunch. Bred in Florida by Martin Stables Incorporated, known by Budget Stable and Team Valor, trained by John Sadler and ridden to victory by Mike Smith, Tasha's Miracle covers the mile in 134.83. We'll head back to Santa Anita for a pair of races from Sunday. We'll kick things off with the Restricted Lure at a mile on turf.
And away they go. All came out smoothly. Langfield from the inside gate, and Matto Mondo is quick in the center, and here's Bonjour coming up to join them with Men's Magazine. Those four quick, and they ensure a quick early pace as well. Global Hunter settling into the fifth position, followed in by Sadler's Trick and Pistol Peter Fleet. Frank the Barber taken back towards the rear, Vauculin behind that, and Mr. Napa Tandy's a good 14 off the leaders. Past the three-quarter pole they go, and Matto Mondo at a strong pace on the outside of Langfield. Those two couldn't be going much quicker for this distance. They lead by three. Men's Magazine got the perfect spot in third, and here's the favorite, Global Hunter, fourth. Gives them six length start. Two more to Bonjour, and then we come back to Sadler's Trick. Up alongside of Sadler's Trick is Pistol Peter Fleet. Then comes Vauculin, Frank the Barber, and last a long way is Mr. Napa Tandy. They strung out over a lot of ground now, less than a half mile to go. Langfield down at the rail and Matto Mondo stride for stride. But it's Men's Magazine now coming after them from third. Global Hunter being confidently ridden in fourth, not being asked, but Global Hunter an obvious contender. In behind that, Pistol Peter Fleet and Vauculin. They're at the top of the lane now, and it's still Langfield and Matto Mondo. They've been tackled now by Men's Magazine, and down the center, Global Hunter. Global Hunter coming home fast. Vauculin getting involved late as well. They come for home. Global Hunter, the leader. Vauculin on the outside. Men's Magazine, Matto Mondo. But it's Global Hunter coming home to score. Global Hunter is one at a length. Vauculo finishes second. Mr. Napa Tandy came flying to snatch third, and Men's Magazine was fourth.
Global Hunter scoring the win. This is a kind of an interesting horse. It might be one to keep your eye on for down the line. He ran very impressively to finish third in the Del Mar Mile. A couple of races last time out. Two races back, finished fourth, but was beaten less than two lengths in the Oak Tree Mile. So he's obviously been facing some very nice horses. A little bit of class relief, and he scores the victory over Vic Halen with Mr. Napper Tandy back in third. The winner, Global Hunter, is a bay son of Jade Hunter from Griff de Paris by Telescopico. Bred in Argentina by La Providencia and owned by Elbow Racing and Monty Pyle. Ridden to victory by Jose Valdivia, Global Hunter covers the mile on the turf in 133.82. Next up, we'll take a look at the 8th and featured allowance race on Sunday afternoon from Santa Anita. A non-winner's a two other than, but it featured the American return to the races of Casino Drive. Let's head back out to California and Sunday's stakes feature, or allowance feature rather, from Santa Anita.
And away they go. In the center, Informed is setting off for the lead by Spotters right there. Casino Drive down at the rail, taking back into third. Asperity from the outside gate. Sensational scores right there. Then Gregorian Bay and Dakota Phone as last. Six lengths would cover the lot. They head to the 7/8 pole now, and going on to lead them is By Spot. Not any hurry at all, though. Slow pace up front. In the second spot, we have Informed. Down at the rail comes Dakota Phone, just a length and a half off them. Now here's the favorite, Casino Drive. Whitecap in fourth, just two lengths off the leaders. Then we come back to Gregorian Bay, up alongside Sensational Score and Asperity. No more than four lengths covers the lot. Past the 5/8 they go, and still By Spot, not in any hurry, leads it a half a length to Informed. Casino Drivers right there in third, down at the rail, Dakota Phone, then it's Asperity, and behind that, Gregorian Bay, and Sensational Score is last still, no more than four lengths covers them all. They have a half mile to go now, and By Spot is still in front of a formed Casino Drive in the white cap right there in third now. Casino Drive still on a tight hold out here, being very confidently ridden. Behind that, Dakota Phone fourth down at the rail. They come into the quarter pole now, and let's see, Casino Drive on the far side still strolling along, takes the advantage. By Spot is going to try to make a race of it. Informed between them, and then Dakota Phone heads a turn for home. Casino Drive is just cantering out here. Can he do it this effortlessly now? Here's Sensational Score going to come testing. Dakota Phone is in there as well. Casino Drive now, he's got to quicken a little. He's just in front, but he's obviously too classy, and he'll remain unbeaten. Casino Drive a length, but never really asked. Dakota Phone second, and Sensational Score was third.
It was Casino Drive running his record to 3-for-3. He had began his career in Japan, ran in the Peter Pan last time out back in May, was prepping up to the Belmont Stakes, and apparently did come up with a little bit of a problem. They did send him back to Japan, and although they had planned on running him during the summertime over there and pointing for a fall campaign here in the United States, he did have a little bit further trouble than they had expected with the foot, apparently, that had been giving him some problems before he left the United States. But seems to be all in good order now as he scores the victory here. Had a nice stalking trip, an easy spot for him, I think it's fair to say, in the return. But Victor Espinosa kept him outside, kept him out of trouble. And when he did have a challenge face him from Dakota Phone, who was a recent winner of the Pomona Derby at Fairplex, he did respond quite nicely. Victor Espinosa shaking the reins and waving the stick at him a few times just to make sure that he still had his attention. The official margin of victory, 3/4 of a length, with Dakota Phone's second Sensational Score rallying to third. The winner, Casino Drive, heads into the Breeders' Cup Classic now with only 3 prior starts, all of them victories, but we'll have to see how he ends up handling things. It's going to be a very different game for him that afternoon. Nonetheless, when he broke his maiden, he did beat a very big field of horses while showing good speed. He is already a winner over the Pro Ride surface, but it is going to be a much bigger test to take on far more experienced rivals in a race like the Breeders' Cup Classic. Casino Drive, certainly well-bred to handle classic performances. He is a 3-year-old son of Mineshaft from Better Than Honor by Deputy Minister, bred in Kentucky by Shell Bloodstock and owned by Hidetoshi Yamamoto, trained by Kazuo Fujisawa and ridden to victory by Victor Espinosa, who, according to early reports, is very likely to retain the mount in the Breeders' Cup. Casino Drive covers the mile in the 16th and 142.14. We'll head to New York now in a pair of weekend stakes, beginning with Saturday's stakes feature, the Athenia for fillies and mares on turf.
And they're off. Walk White's Love comes out first. Criminologist gets off to a good start. And from the outside, Sunshine for Life now to take the lead. So Sunshine for Life takes command early on, strides away to lead now by almost 2.5 lengths. Walk White's Love is second outside the favorite Criminologist. In behind Criminologist is Criticism. In the clear on the outside is Classic Neil. At the back are ODNO and Social Queen. So Sunshine for Life gets a clear, uncontested, easy lead. A 24-2 opening half mile. Sunshine for Life out there now by 4. Walk White's Love continues on in second. Criminologist third toward the inside with 5 furlongs to go. Criticism's in between horses. Classic Neil on the outside. ODNO, the back markers with Social Queen. It was an easy half mile here for the front runner, Sunshine for Life. 48 1/5 seconds. Still loose on the lead as Sunshine for Life. Walk White's Love continues on in second. Criminologist still sitting chilly. A cool and calculated third with 3 furlongs to go. Classic Neil advancing willingly on the outside. Criticism now back in fifth. Coming to the top of the stretch, whittling away at the lead of Sunshine for Life, who hits the top of the lane clear by 2. Criminologist on the inside, Walk White's Love between horses. Here's Criticism kicking in. Classic Neil on the outside. Sunshine for Life strikes the eighth pole, clear by 2. Criticism and Criminologist both getting to her. It's still Sunshine for Life. Sunshine for Life and Criticism, and they're coming down to the line. Sunshine for Life holds on. Channing Hill got away with those easy fractions and held on to beat Criticism by a long neck. Criminologist was third.
Sunshine for Life scoring the upset victory here on the front end. And when she gets to the front end and is able to shake loose, she is deadly. She did so at 14-1 last time out in Saratoga. She was given a little bit of time off. Returns was able to take a quick mare like Wacoit's Love right out of her game by showing her good early speed. She was stalked in this race by Wacoit's Love. Interestingly enough, Criminologist, who generally does her best running from far back, a little closer to the pace here, that might have affected her. She has to settle for second with Criticism rallying strongly to finish in the second spot as Criminologist settles for third. The winner, Sunshine for Life, dangerous on the front end, this chestnut daughter of Giant's Causeway from Million Stories by Exclusive Native. She was bred in Kentucky by the Buckram Oak Farm and is owned by Jane M. Schossberg. Trained by Richard Schossberg and ridden to victory by Channing Hill, Sunshine for Life covers the mile in the 16th at Belmont Park on a turf labeled firm in 141.55. We'll head right back to Belmont for Sunday's stakes feature, the extra heat for fillies and mares on turf.
And they're off, stumbling soon after the break was Troublemaker. There's Sheets like a shot from the rail. Sheets quickly, 2.5 in front. Now, 3 lengths in front is Sheets. HouseQuest second on the outside, followed by Mohegan Sky. And on the far outside, Smart and Fancy. Then Troublemaker and Diamondrella. And it's Sheets blazing the way into the far turn. Through a quarter in 22 2/5 seconds. Clear by 4 from HouseQuest. And it's another 3.5 lengths back to Mohegan Sky and Smart and Fancy. Diamondrella Troublemaker still at the back. Sheets by 3. HouseQuest getting closer, coming to the top of the stretch. Sheets turns for home in front. HouseQuest not far behind now after a 45 flat half mile. Farther back, Diamondrella is getting underway. Now there's 1 furlong to go. Edgar Prado gets to work on Sheets, pleading for 1 more furlong. Here's HouseQuest. Here's Smart and Fancy. Here's Diamondrella. Sheets maybe. Here's Diamondrella and Smart and Fancy. Diamondrella and Smart and Fancy. A nose apart on the wire, and it was a 3-way photo for show among HouseQuest, Sheets, and Troublemaker.
This time it's sprinting fillies and mares on turf, and Diamondrella scoring by a nose from off the pace, being fanned wide. You'll often see in those turf sprints, they corner very quickly and horses end up very, very wide. Diamondrella, one of them, but she manages to get her nose down on the wire in front of the very good Smart and Fancy. Sheets completes the order of the top 3 after sprinting clear early. The winner, Diamondrella, won the Positive Gal in overnight stakes here at Belmont in early September off of a July layoff. Now 2-for-2 for the autumn season here at Belmont Park. Diamondrella is a bay filly, a daughter of Rock of Gibraltar from Tap Your Feet by Dixieland Band. Bred in Great Britain by William S. Farish and owned by the Castletop Stable. trained by Angel Pena Jr. and ridden to victory by Rajiv Mirage. Diamondrella covers the six furlongs on the firm Belmont turf in 108.92. That'll wrap up this week's edition of Horses and Courses. Thank you for joining us. We hope you'll be able to join us again next time as we take a look at stakes racing action from around the country. Until then, I'm Jean Wood. Have a great week at the races.